welcome everybody here in Twitch chats and everyone on YouTube who's watching this video later on over there for some ranked matches in Mythic here with Judith Priest. All right, so this was a deck that we played last format. It was all right. It wasn't like one of the best decks or anything like that, but it was pretty fun. The reason why it's called Judith Priest is because it's based around two cards from Ravnica Allegiance, Judith the Scourge Diva and Priest of Forgotten Gods. Both those cards are really powerful and can do a lot of really good things for you, but you know, we have to kind of build around them. The problems that the deck had before is it didn't have a very good top end, and the two drop slot besides Priest of Forgotten Gods was pretty bad. And I'm thinking that War of the Spark can really help out in both of those areas. So first of all, in the top end, we got Chandra Fire Artisan now, which is basically perfect for this deck. It gets us the card advantage that the deck kind of needs at times, you know, just like every deck in Standard can use more card advantage, while also pressuring opponents, you know, because if opponents want to attack Chandra, they're going to be taking damage, and all that damage adds up, especially when you're playing things like Judith, Dreadhorde Butcher, Priest, that Firebrand even, that all like deal damage to the opponent. And then the two drop slot, we have Dreadhorde Butcher, which is just awesome. This card is just, it's just really good. Like, the haste is awesome in this format with so many little Teferis running around. Even though the little Teferi can bounce this and reset it, still just having haste is really good. And then of course it has that ability of whenever it dies, it deals damage to any target, which is exactly what this deck is wanting to do. And then we have Lazotep Reaver. Before I was playing Goblin Instigator, that card was meh, you know, it was all right. And this card, still all right, but I think it's an upgrade. You know, you get a 1-2, that's a whole lot better than being a 1-1, you know, so you get something with two toughness, especially when there's like Chain Whirlers around and everything. The second toughness is really nice. And whether it's like a mass one or make a 1-1, that's not a huge difference. I mean, you know, you can have like one, if you play like one Lazotep Reaver and then you play another, you just turn your first 1-1 token into a 2-2. And you know, maybe that 2-2 then helps attack into like other 2-2s and stuff. But played a few games with this and I was just kind of impressed at how it works out. So the two bodies is something that's pretty important for a lot of cards in our deck. It's important for having Priest, you know, we can just play the Lazotep Reaver and then activate Priest. It's nice that it's black also instead of red, so that like whenever we add two black mana with Priest, we can immediately cast Lazotep Reaver where we couldn't cast the Goblin, is it Instigator or whatever the name of that other Goblin card is. So that's a good help. Multiple bodies are good with like Midnight Reaper. Now, of course, Midnight Reaper only triggers on the creature, not on the token, because it's non-token. But still, we can you know, chump block with like the regular creature or sack it to Priest and draw a card while we still have another body. And of course, then there's Judith, where Judith can pump up both bodies too. So yeah, I'm pretty excited about this one. It ran pretty smooth whenever I was playing it earlier, so let's go ahead and give it a try. Sideboard, we got a couple Elder Spells because of how many Planeswalkers there are these days. Elder Spell is never really been more solid than it is right now. And we got Finale of Eternity against other creature decks that are going wide or other aggro decks where we didn't have this before. Like, other aggro decks were certainly a problem for us, and hopefully Finale of Eternity helps those matchups out. All right. Yeah, the Fire and Steel we still have in the sideboard. We got a couple Angrats here on the board. Yeah, no God Eternal Bantus. Now we're trying to be more aggressive than God Eternal Bantus. Yeah, Mono Red is good in best of three still. You can see I was playing it there. All right, Judith Priest. So whenever we're playing these ranked matches where we're at in Mythic, these are pretty tough matches. So going 3-2 is a really good sign. So that's our goal, is just to go 3-2 with these decks here in Mythic ranked. Because we're going to be playing 5 matches for each deck. All right, good Six card hand. I guess I didn't really even talk about Legion Warboss. The whole reason why I thought about playing this deck was actually because how good Legion Warboss is against Lil Teferi. Memorial to War? That's not very common. So I'm going to have to... So basically, like, by playing the Mountain here, I'm going to have to pay 2 life for this Blood Crypt. Gobos, okay. But now the Butcher can come on in. All right, no shock for our opponent. That's good. I think it's more important to get Warboss going. Keep on trading and dealing damage to them. We're going to be ahead. Get to keep on doing that. So goblins, huh? Well, I guess I want Finale of Eternity against goblins, I guess. Maybe not Midnight Reaper? Maybe a Phoenix. All right, so I'm just going to take out the Midnight Reapers, play a couple Finales and a Phoenix. All right, game two. I don't know if I've played against goblins since War of the Spark's been out. And seeing goblins in Mythic is really surprising. Definitely be better on the draw, but we're keeping. Ooh. Yeah, I don't actually know very much about the banned Judas Priest either. These goblins are wily. Now that's meta. Using a Wily Goblin to play another Wily Goblin. Using the treasure from one. I think I'm going to wait with the Butcher. Just 2 1-1s. I don't really want to trade with 2 1-1s with this Dreadhorde Butcher. So we'll just have this War Boss that can make more 1-1s. Especially with me having this Finale in my hand. Okay, so what does this count? Toughness? Ooh. next turn, we should have a really, really good turn next turn. You know, we'll see if we do or not, but I think we will. We'll see what we got. Krenko. Dark Dweller, okay. We don't get to divide this damage, right? No, it just deals it'll just deal the two. Wait. Z. Yeah, because I want to play this also, so I want the red mana to play that. Let's activate. I should have just done this too. They're just going to sack this Wily Goblin, I guess. Alright, well, this didn't go as well. They're just going to sack that Wily Goblin. I should have done the 2-2 to kill the Wily Goblin and then make them sack a different one. Okay. So that's 2 and then 3. So they destroy all those. Play another Butcher, attack on in. All right, gotta win. So starting off strong. We had a bunch of Dreadhorde Butchers and Legion War Bosses. Hopefully we didn't use all of our good hands there in that match. Ew. Really? Our deck doesn't mulligan that well, admittedly, as you can tell. Well, if we can just top deck 3 lands, maybe get to this Chandra. Never mind. There's not really any situation that you wouldn't want to play first in Standard. You should choose to play first every time. So Jund, huh? I guess I trade this for Growth Chamber Guardian if they want. Hey, Chronic Slayer, going good so far. We won our first one. We got paired against goblins here in Mythic, which you don't see very often. That was our first match, and now we're on a mold of 5 here. All right, so Judith will do the extra 1 point of damage to the Growth Chamber Guardian, then we'll deal 3 to them. I will protect the virtue Nissa. Of this world. It's a little risky.
Harness the elements.
Hmm. Thorn Lieutenant's really nice. That extra ability there. I ping it to death. I get that extra 1/1. It's really annoying.
Play with fire, huh? What's that smell? Oh, it's you burning.
If that was just Overgrown Tomb, I would have been attacking in with both my creatures. And trading Judith for Overgrown Tomb, with them having that Thorn Lieutenant there, really nice. Thanks, Kaishka. Yeah, we got some sweet ones today.
You won't see the end coming until it's too late.
Killing the Firebrand, huh? So we have to do 2 damage. Let's go upstairs. I don't know if we win like a elongated game.
Be wary of the ground you walk on.
I think I just go upstairs. Man, I'm not beating this Nissa, though. Oh, maybe we are. Probably not, but maybe we are. I'm a fan of tomb vandalism. Yeah, that tomb was getting too overgrown. Had to be taken out. Hey, Carinadas! Or Carinadras. Carindras. There we go. Carandras. Maybe one of those. Anyway, thank you so much for that donation. It says, love your stream. Could you play this deck? If you have time today, it would be great. All right, what do we got? Ooh. A Grixis. I guess it's Grixis Control. Is the best to name this. There are so many. So many cool cards. Hey, what's up, Gatsby? Here's the link there. Soul Diviner in there and everything. Yeah, and this is really good. Alright. Let's try again. I know we got them down to 6. And our mold to 5. Not the worst. Get a couple finales in here. Seem like they're going to be struggling against Phoenix. Phoenix looks really good against them. I think again, though, they're going to be kind of aggressive. We'll take out our Midnight Reapers. And maybe a couple shocks. Shock didn't really seem like it killed very much. I mean, I guess like Growth Chamber Guardian. But they're going to be killing my stuff. I think let's put in a Lava Coil and take out the 3 shocks. So yeah, basically for the Grixis deck for today, we need to replace the Dimir control deck. Because I don't think I want to do Dimir and Grixis. So we'll just move Dimir control to tomorrow. I keep on moving this. That's all right. So we have, I guess it's Grixis control. No 2-drop. Just keep. Let's try to draw a couple lands. Ooh, getting there. Aesthetic with the Twitch Prime sub. Thanks, Aesthetic. They're a Dreadhorde Butcher deck. Are we all Dreadhorde Butcher's decks? I guess the answer is yes. I need to get this Butcher off the battlefield. I don't have a good way to do it. If I knew that they were a Butcher deck, would have... So they missed a land drop, huh? Would have kept in my shocks. I would have thought they would have Dreadhorde Butcher. I thought they're going to be a lot more Planeswalker heavy. So I guess my plan is to sit back and block. It's not a great plan. Nah, my plan's not to sit back and block. With the Butcher, that is. Okay. So I can play Judith and trade Judith and Butcher for their Growth Chamber Guardian and Butcher. Or I can just play Phoenix. Just gonna do the former. Okay. A land would have been nice there for this finale. Kind of nice. But I don't know if the finale is that great anyway right now. But definitely just going to get the priest in play and just kind of see what happens with this priest. Well, I will trade Priest for Butcher. Priest and half a Phoenix, that is. Storm, I just played against Simic Yoink from yesterday. They wanted to mass manipulate my Teferi and Niv-Mizzet. Never has an Absorb felt better. Very nice. All right, so they're down to two cards. We got three cards. Battlefield's clear. Those Dreadhorde Butchers did their thing. Oh, no.
We will not fail.
That's a good one.
The land fights for us.
Freeze is a great draw. Nissa's so good though. Yeah, I didn't sideboard well against them having Dreadhorde Butcher for sure. I think I only brought in one coil. Definitely need both coils. Like, this is. Coil is, like, insanely good in this matchup. Oh, come on. Angrath, too? Bleh. Alright, well, we lost. Run. We're not going to beat the Nissa. Now, with the Angrath back up.
A fair price.
Yeah, opponent's deck is awesome. They've played well.
My Their deck's cool. Friend.
Good games. All right, 1-1. It's a cool deck. Kind of similar stuff to what we had with like the Phoenixes and everything, but they went bigger. All right, I like this hand quite a bit. Got a 1-2 and a 3. Hand on the play. And hopefully we draw some more 3s to follow up. All right, Rivale. We're gonna go wide. Mm. Wild Growth Walker is such a beating. Such a beating. Yeah, we're playing a bunch of commons here. We need Midnight Reaper, Judith. Priest of Forgotten Gods. Be really nice. Hey, thanks, Chandler. For the 26-month streak, you're still the best, Todd. Aw, thank you so much. Wild Growth Walker, definitely a beating. Next sub battle's not scheduled yet. We are six sub goals away from getting to the next sub battle right now, so haven't scheduled it yet.
The ends justify the means.
That's why I should have played the swamp earlier. So I don't get this Gutter Bones back, so we didn't deal any damage to them. We get to cycle it, though.
I'm going to make that. I won't forgive this.
Time to attack. You think I play this opponent Ragnaros often? I don't really recognize the name, honestly. But maybe I do. Gain 12 life with this Wild Growth Walker. We're trying over here. You know, they got to gain 12 life. Sultai was always a real big thorn in this deck's side, and you know, last format there was so much Sultai being played. Another thing that I was excited about playing this deck was people don't really play very much Sultai, but our opponent still is, and destroyed us pretty good there. Got us pretty good. So I guess we need to just try to go big here and have all this kind of stuff in. Take out War Boss. War Boss and Lazotep Reaver are like the two cards that I'm definitely looking at. As you can tell, I don't have like a ton against Wild Growth Walker in general. By the time, like, it'll get out of Finale of Eternity range pretty quickly. That's true. If we do play like a really longer game, Finale of Eternity can still be good. Yeah, it's not CMC though. It's toughness, so it's tough to kill Wild Growth Walker with this. That could definitely be a flaw in my sideboard, not having enough answers to the Walker. I just added in a bunch of fours and fives. I'm definitely not taking out land. I'm going to go this way so that we can double spell with the one drops on turn two. Never mind, just playing Butcher. Butcher too strong. Good land. Now, just get out of here, Land War Elf. No Land War Elves for you. Haunted on.
You and I are gonna take him out. There's no problem fire can't solve.
No. Yay. All right, time to light it up. Time to light it up. This is definitely a really good hand for us on the play. We'll take it.
Now you've done it!
Kind of feels like my opponent may have like a Cry of the Carnarium, which would be bad. Please just be Ritual of Soot. Ooh, Finale of Eternity.
burning.
Finale of Eternity card's really good. I like that one. Good job, Midnight Reaper. All right, let's go, Chandra. More cards.
This is just gonna be bad for
Love
you.
It. See, Chandra's been just awesome. Chandra really is like what this deck, like a real big piece of what this deck was missing. New card.
There's no problem fire can't solve.
I've been looking for. Alright, so we'll make them sacrifice. Sack the priest and the Judith. Two Judith triggers. We'll kill the branch walker. Sack the Krasis. Get the new Judith in play. Plus the Butcher. Plus pick up this Gutter Bones, put it in my hand. Yep, when Chandra, if you minus 7 Chandra, she deals 7 damage because 7 loyalty counters are removed from Chandra. Yeah, Chandra definitely won this game. What about Demir Control from yesterday, Poner? Yeah, I was planning on playing that today. I had it up on the schedule at first. But then we just got a donation for Grixis Control, and don't really want to play Grixis and Demir. And so it's getting pushed back one more day. Yeah, they're pretty dead. You're welcome. So I guess I should change my stream title, says Demir Control. I should change the stream title. I guess Angrath takes out Wild Growth Walker pretty well. I know Contempt in the sideboard because it just costs a lot of mana. Like we're an aggro deck and 4 mana for a removal spell is a lot. When is a great time to open your vault? Basically anytime you want. Like there's no like time that's better than any others. I usually just open it whenever I get it, because you just get, like, you're gonna get wild cards no matter what. Bedevil could certainly be a sideboard card. For sure. Be in the slot that I have Elder Spell. Yeah, you could play Bedevil. There. But yeah, if you don't open it, then you can tell, yep, exactly. You can tell your progress if you're not opening it. Hmm. So they play the priest. I could Angrath Steel Priest. Activate it. I don't think they're activating my priest. I don't really have a good block. I wouldn't be surprised if they take it. If they do take it, then it just makes the butcher better. Hey, what's up, Zerf? Cajun guy, how's it going? Alright, so taking out Hostage Taker and Priest. Shocking in at 6 mana. That means Krasis. Tilt. That's an easy trade. I guess I'm going to take 3.
Here be
getting that crisis.
Your crew for my freedom. A fair price.
So I can attack for 9 and just let the Angrath die. Put them down to 9. Or I could just hit for 5 and like try to have these chump for the Angrath. I think we're gonna chump for Angrath. I guess it would have been 10 and put them down to 8 because of that trigger. I forgot about that Judith trigger right there. I should have just attacked. We did get the cast down out of their hand. I don't know. It's a lot of creatures. We didn't actually get anything out of Zangrath.
No.
Alright, well, I definitely should have just done the attacking with everything. Certainly.
I know. I'll sit back and watch it burn.
So I'll have Priest get Hostage Taker. Okay, so my decision of protect Angrath ended up being really wrong with my opponent being able to just empty their hand. Then they had this Hostage Taker on top. That just didn't work out at all. So it certainly cost me this. Looks like it will. Should have just attacked with all my creatures.
No steal.
Let the Angrath die. Keep the Judith.
burning.
That double Branchwalker 3-2 was awesome for them. Like, being able to... Like, they had four cards in hand. They had cast down Branchwalker, Branchwalker, land, and they had the six mana. That was just... That was really great. Being able to play all that there, all 3-2s. That was... But still, that was... That used to be... Like, just a really, really bad matchup for this deck before. But we saw, like, those were some close games for sure. And, yeah, good sign for our deck for playing, like, Sultai that close, which Sultai has just so many problematic things. And we played him that close there. I don't think you need to play a card like Heartfire to... try to have a finisher of killing your Chandra and making it so to kill people for lethal. I think you just want cards that are good all the time, not cards that are situationally good if you get your opponent down low, plus you have a Chandra in play, and then it's good. Hey, Trunks. Shocking that. No, plan is for tomorrow, though. That's the plan. Tezzeret deck tomorrow. Well, normally I'd want to play Priest here, but they have a Lightning Strike or a Shock. Something they're shocking in for.
Oh, I look forward to seeing you running away. I bow to no one.
Cool. We got some fried bones. Domri's awesome. Yeah, playing the Tron deck later. Had a donation for that. And this is why Domri's awesome. Because he gets to kill Priest.
Ooh, I revel in devastation.
Unfortunately, you don't get to actually kill the Phoenix Egg. But I'll just trade Gutter Bones for Llanowar Elf.
Oh, I wish you could see your face while I'm beating you.
Two Phoenixes. Phoenix is so good against me. I don't have anything on my main deck for Phoenix, really. Gosh, Phoenix is awesome. I only have like these two coils and my own Phoenixes to fight them. Yeah, Phoenix is rough. Take out the Reaver and two War Boss. No, one Reaper, one War Boss. I haven't done very much with Reaver in just these three little matches that we've played, but I played a couple matches with this off stream and Reaver was pretty solid. It it makes Reaver makes a lot of your other cards better. It makes cards like Priest, Judith, Midnight Reaper, all those things better. And even War Boss, it helps you go wide. Okay, King J. Nice. So I only have one red source right now, which is unfortunate. So like, even if I would like play the other Firebrand and activate Priest, we just have three black mana, so I wouldn't be able to play Judith or anything. We had all the land last game. Couldn't bring any of it over to this game. That's how it works. When you keep the five lander, you just draw more lands. Keep the two lander, you don't draw lands. That's how it works. Let's see how far these firebrands can take us. I like a J. Looks pretty solid. So I can sack both Firebrands to kill the Spellbreaker. Trading two Firebrands for a Spellbreaker worth it? Probably not. We'll probably do better than that. I could attack with one Firebrand, and if they block, then I would get like the extra trigger, so I would be able to kill the Spellbreaker and deal one damage to them. Annoying. It's really annoying. And of course, and maybe I should have. And of course, now, like with the Spellbreaker on their turn, not only them, but then also the Spellbreaker has haste, or sorry, has hexproof, so I can't really target anything with the fire. You know, if I would shoot Firebrands, I'd just killing that Daredevil. Where's the lands? That's unfortunate. Card advantage. Good card advantage can you add in a mid-range Gruul deck? You can have the Explore package. Some good card advantage. You can have Chandra, Vivian, either Vivian. Phoenix is basically card advantage. Sarkhan gets you like a body and a planeswalker.
It's my turn. There's no problem fire can't solve.
Yeah, get that Nissa out of here. I can't beat Nissa. Get that out of here. Really wish I would have just killed the Spellbreaker. I guess I would have had the shock for the Daredevil, and now this Butcher would have been able to hit in. Just can't get this fourth land. I need to be dropping Phoenixes. Bleh. We're going to trade the Butcher and a Shock to get that thing out of here. And hopefully draw the fourth land next turn.
Sit back and watch it burn.
On deck, draw fourth land next turn. These big green creature decks are giving us trouble. We lost to like basically this deck, but Jund earlier. And then we lost to Sultai, and now we're losing to this deck. Yeah, saying Fibble, Thib, and Gruul, that doesn't make any sense. I think that was a joke, I think. I don't think that makes any sense. Well, unfortunately, they have Lava Coils. I mean, I could just try another Phoenix. I mean, this Chandra is going to kill us. Oh, because he's lost. Gotcha. All right, Judith Priest isn't helping us too much here. Let's try not to play against a Wild Growth Walker, Growth Chamber, or Wild Growth Walker or Rekindling Phoenix deck. I don't want to see those two cards. Don't want to see him. Okay. We can't. Well, yeah, maybe we. Yeah. So we could have just like Chandra on four after. Alright, Glacial Fortress. Usually I'd want to play Priest. Dreadhorde Butcher is really good too. Hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna play Priest. Oh, well, it's not a creature deck. So I guess I didn't need the Priest last turn. I was kind of thinking it was gonna be like Bant or Esper Hero. Maybe one of those. Especially like Esper Hero.
I'm known for my excellent timing. No, I am not.
No, that's fine.
I
don't need to play that card again.
It's only a matter of time.
Gideon gets haste when he comes back from Prison Realm. That must be a bug in Arena, because, yeah, Gideon should not have haste when it comes back to Prison Realm. Hey, Exor. Yep, good luck. All these beacons. Triple beacon, that's so much life. All right, this thing, like, makes some tutus.
My students are loyal and
tutus are pretty decent. All right, it's just spells.
Hmm.
Oh no, fight whales. Sorry, you have 14 hours there. You'll make it through it. You'll make it through it. You'll do good with your 14-hour workday.
Focus on what matters.
Triple interplanar beacon.
I train ever with thoughtfulness before action.
All right, so I need this priest to start giving us a bunch of triggers with, like, Judith and everything. I can't draw extra cards with Midnight Reaper right now with Narset in play. This triple beacon is helping keep our opponent alive. They could of course just have a sweeper, and that'd be really bad for me. Hope it not. Hey, D. Salita, howdy. You have two of the same card in hand, and one is revealed. If you play the non-revealed, it hides the back copy. Yep, absolutely. So yeah, it'll just, you know, it checks like the art. So you're good. You don't have to worry about necessarily playing the exact revealed one. Play Bant Midrange. I haven't really played Bant Midrange. I don't have like a specific list. Oh my gosh, sweeper. Well, that's game. Yeah, I mean, this is just game. Why can't I want to say good game, but I can't say good game. Triple interplanar beacon. Hopefully they did not have that. Let's get a bunch of duresses. All right, so I need to worry about... To be honest, I wasn't really... I don't know, I wasn't really expecting sweepers, to be honest. I could have played around a sweeper better. Do I just want to take out Reaver? Yeah, I'll just take out Reaver completely. For Phoenix. No, I need two drops. Don't want Priest. Maybe I'll just keep Priest. I'll just keep two Priests. Yeah, I guess we would have drawn a bunch of cards there. I think it was pretty over with them just gaining so much life, like having a lot more mana than us, gaining a bunch of life every turn for every planeswalker. I don't know, maybe it wasn't. I probably just conceded way too early. Coil and Clarion. Those are two really good cards. I guess I take the Clarion. I don't know if I would have been fine with drawing after I drew the cards, but yeah, maybe I could have. No, because Mina did nothing to the pings or anything. Because Mina only says when it's a spell, not an ability. Teferi's great against Judith there.
This might be a bad idea.
No, man, I would have loved to have that war boss last turn. Ping off the Teferi there. Oh god, Prison Realm? Well, this is just going horribly for me.
I am out of here.
Yeah, I don't know. Don't tell me what my opponent has in chat. What are you doing? Yeah, we gotta just Dreadhorde Butcher. Yeah, opponent was just gonna be gaining so much life from those beacons. And like that Ugin was good, like Ugin just taking up all the time.
Magnificent!
Hard for my worst defeat.
So I'd rather just trade the Gutter Bones for the dragon. I don't want to trade the Dreadhorde Butcher for the dragon.
Listen up, and I'll teach you a trick or two. Join my cause.
I think that's about it. I didn't bring in Phoenix, did I?
My brow will keep an open
mind. Narset's a great one.
Hone your control.
Wow, and they discarded that? They've drawn very well. After keeping that four land hand, they've just drawn one land. Our three lander has turned into four more lands. It's a little unfortunate.
Meditate and prepare.
Dreadhorde Butcher is just awesome. It's one of the very best cards in our deck.
Trust me, you'll thank me later. Don't worry, I got this.
I just don't have good options. This card is just not going to beat all these things at all. So, I mean, I can shoot our opponent, pick up Gutterbones, and replay it. I can ping either of those Planeswalkers. It's just not going to do enough.
I'll protect you.
Yeah, too much card advantage for us. That exile spell on my Chandra was awesome. Like, everything was just kind of perfect there. Like, the Teferi bounced the Judith, then the exile on the Chandra when I didn't play more creatures to attack the Teferi. It didn't work out for me. The game one, maybe I had a chance. That was a little bit of me being on tilt after losing three matches in a row and then having all my creatures die to that sweeper. But maybe I had a chance there. And, like, the triple gain life. War Boss is good against Teferi. Krenko is horrible against Teferi. That's, like, the big reason to play War Boss, because there's lots of Teferis around. War Boss is also just a better card just in a lot of other aspects, but that's, like, that's an easy one just to kind of say of why War Boss instead of Krenko. So
we went 1-4.
I don't know. I feel like I need more Lava Coils. We're really struggling against the other creature decks in particular. Yeah, this is my list, Spellcaster. I was 3-0 with the deck off stream, so I really liked it. I was excited to play it. But then, yeah, like those bigger green creature decks, we were just struggling and not quite able to get the games away. And then, I don't know, that last match. Whatever.
Is Elderspell necessary? Probably not. Maybe not. Like, maybe we just don't need Elderspell. Maybe, like, I wanted to try Shock in here instead of Coil. And I did like the Shocks, but maybe you just need Coil also. Those other, yeah, like, the big green creature decks, like, basically big green creatures are, that's tough. Could have Status to pair with Judith for the status, for a combo with Judith. So Status, you know, it does give, like, your creature death touch. So, yeah, all those, if you get multiple Judith pings, you can try to mow stuff down. It's interesting. I don't know if that will happen too often. But. Bedevil wouldn't hurt. Yeah, Bedevil's probably the card. That's probably the card, honestly. I think Bedevil's the card. Let's go. Yeah, we talked about that one, like, towards the beginning of the league. That's honestly probably the card I need. I think I want two Shocks, one Bedevil, and let's get just some more Bedevils over here instead of Elder Spell. There's just so many threes, though. 12 threes. See, Coil gets rid of Phoenix, though. Phoenix has been a problem. I'm going to go one Coil main instead of the one Bedevil main. And then that makes it 12 and 11, 12-2, 11-3 instead of the other way around. And then just replace Elder Spell with Bedevil. I like that. I like Bedevil more than Elder Spell. You've had more success with priest decks when you put two priests in the sideboard because of the so many creature-less archetypes. Right, but those are... The creature-less archetypes are not really the ones I'm losing to. I mean, obviously we just lost to that last one, but whatever. But that's not... Normally that's not what I'm losing to. I'm losing to the green creature decks when I don't have priest. Angrass Rampage? That's certainly an option. Yeah, Rampage is an option. Doesn't get rid of Phoenix, but... Yeah, I like Rampage. It costs two. I forgot about Rampage. Because, like, other creatures, you get to, like... You know, you can try to, like, kill off other creatures and everything. And this can get, like, a big creature. Rampage is not bad. I like two a whole lot more than three. You can even use Rampage against yourself to, like, trigger Butcher or Judith or something like that if you need to. I mean, it's just something you could do. Or Midnight Reaper if you're playing against a... I don't know when you'd really do that too much. Hey, what's up, Matthew? Angrath comes in against lower decks. Or, like, Angrath's even just better after sideboarding. After sideboarding, everybody has more removal against you. And so going bigger with a card like Angrath is really nice. Is this better than Shock? I could see that. I'd be willing to try it out. I'd be willing just to try this out. Like, just try these two cards out. Because I just haven't played those two cards, these two removal spells in this kind of deck. Maybe we just try out two Angrass Rampage and a Bedevil instead of the Shocks. I was, like, shocking Land War Elves quite a bit earlier. And then maybe three Lava Coil on the sideboard. So we can get rid of Phoenixes. Yeah, I'm willing to try that out. Oh, you have other ways to get rid of Hero Thief. Yeah, I'm willing to try this out. That'd be good. Yeah, Chandra is much, much better than Theater Force. Miles better. Like, not, like, Theater Horrors just really isn't close. All right, so that's Judith Priest. Yeah, we didn't do as well. We played a lot of close games, a lot of good games. The deck's close, and, yeah, I'll keep on working on it. I'll try out, like, these Angrass Rampages and Bedevil and stuff like that, see how that goes. Yeah, it's pretty sweet. All right, so if you're watching this video later on YouTube, hope you enjoyed it. But thank you so much for watching. Hope you hit the like and the subscribe button over there. And that's it for Judith Priest, and I will see you for another video.